Tom Tillis suddenly finds himself facing a primary challenger, a challenger who donated money to the Tillis campaign back in 2014. Both the challenger, Garland Tucker, and Senator Tillis are competing over who is more loyal to the president. Today's visit by Vice President Mike Pence shows the administration is now favoring Tillis. Senator Tillis has voted with the president 95% of the time. But his most notable vote involved Mr. Trump's emergency declaration to build a wall. Tillis defied the president in an op-ed in the Washington Post. But the backlash from North Carolina Republicans was so great that Tillis changed his vote. Now Vice President Mike Pence comes to Greensboro to help raise money for the Tillis campaign.
Yeah, I think that it is significant for a sitting senator or a challenger for that matter to get a strong sign from a presidential administration that they've got that support.
Tillis's primary opponent told WXII 12 News in a recent interview how much he supports President Trump. Garland Tucker, a retired Raleigh businessman, says Tillis has betrayed his conservative values and conservative groups rate him poorly.
Senator Tillis is at 51%. That's kind of, I would say that's a half a conservative. And I think North Carolina Republicans and independents who will be voting in this primary want a more conservative voice than Senator Tillis.
Senator Tillis didn't fare well in a poll conducted by High Point University last February. Only 23% of those polled approved of the job he's doing. 33% disapproved, 44% said they didn't know. High Point University political scientist Martin Kiefer says Democrats would rather see the challenger, Garland Tucker, take out incumbent Tom Tillis in the GOP primary.
That a guy who claims to be further to the right, does he really have a better chance of winning a general election in North Carolina?
All other things being equal, more extreme candidates have less of a chance of winning, particularly in a presidential year.
Tillis's poll numbers from last February don't look very good, but High Point political scientist Martin Kiefer says it is typical for voters not to have an opinion of their senator. He says they have an opinion of the president, they have an opinion of the governor, but oftentimes they have no view on their senator. In Greensboro, waiting for Vice President Mike Pence, I'm Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News.